notice, even though there are colleges named University of Tennessee at Chattanooga, we don't have the orange in our colors. In fact, we have a fairly usual one on today with the gray, but our colors are blue and gold. That's kind of, we're the only UT campus that doesn't have orange in our colors, but for a specific reason. For the first 83 years, from 1886 until 1968, we were a Methodist college, and we were the University of Chattanooga. And so, and by part of the merger agreement, we merged with the University of Tennessee system. Part of that agreement was we got to keep our colors, and they have to maintain our two chapels on campus. And so we're probably, we have a little different flavor than most of the UT campuses because of that, but we still have two active chapels. So this particular chorus is one of five choruses on campus. This is a chorus that does most of the traveling. They just got back from a tour of Ireland and Scotland in May, and were able to sing in some really nice places. We sang in Christchurch Cathedral in Dublin, and St. Giles in Edinburgh, Scotland, and lots of little places. Got to see some wonderful cities on the way. But what we wanted to do today is to come into East Tennessee and sing for some schools. I started a rule a long time ago that at some point, every one of our alumnus that's out teaching, we will go to their school and sing, because we all want to do that for them. And it's been a while. It took us a while to get up here, so we're glad to have come. The next piece we're going to do is actually a piece that's from a larger work called The All Night Vigil by Sergei Rachmaninoff. So it's a Russian piece. It'll have a little darker sound. And it's also a setting of the Ave Maria, but it's in Church Slavonic. So the text, the title of the work is actually Bogorodica Dievo, but it's a set of the Orthodox setting of the Ave Maria. noted, it'll tell you who they are, where they're from, what they're majoring in. And we'll sing another piece. And after that piece, I want you to be thinking about any questions that you might have. It can be anything. It can be about music degrees, or it could be about what's it like to just be in college and have a different schedule, or anything you can think of. We'll turn the floor over to them and let them answer questions for you. Okay, so let's start with Sophie.
Hi, I'm Sophie. I'm a junior, and I'm double majoring in political science and music. I'm from Chattanooga.
My name is Jasmine. I'm a junior vocal music education major in the public.
I'm Kristen. I'm a junior vocal music education major from Chattanooga.
I'm Morgan. I'm a junior and a vocal music education major, and I'm from Chattanooga.
I'm Taylor. I'm a junior vocal music education major. I'm from Knoxville. I went to Cards.
My name is Brandon Littlebrooks. I'm a junior vocal music education major, and I'm from Trenton, Georgia.
I'm Sarah. I'm a senior biology major and music minor, and I'm from Kingsport, Kentucky.
I'm Benjamin Brooks. I am a junior vocal performance major, and I'm from Morrison.
I'm Kayla. I'm a senior vocal performance major, and I'm from Mount Juliet.
I'm Gerard. I'm a senior vocal music education major, and I'm from Chattanooga.
My name is Corey Sperling. I'm a freshman marketing major, and I just graduated last year from Webb.
My name is Nathan Short. I am a junior vocal music education major, and I went to Walker Valley High School in Cleveland, Tennessee.
I'm Alec. I'm a super senior vocal performance major, and I'm from Mount Juliet.
I'm Glory. I'm a senior vocal music education major, and I went to Center for Creative Arts in Chattanooga.
Something about bases and being super senior. Into the world of this, right on. We have just finished a project that you may have been involved in the beginning of it, with the recording of the spirituals of Roland Carter. Roland Carter is an internationally known composer and arranger of spirituals. And so his, you may hear a good bit this month especially, his arrangement of Lift Every Voice and Sing. It is by far the most popular one that's done. That one is on our latest CD, but our volume one, your teacher, Mr. Darnell, was on, and volume two we just released last year, and we left some copies of that with him. This is something from volume one, so the piece that you'll know, you can come and join us if you want to. Right on. Because I'm recycling this year from about 7 or 8 years ago. All right, here we go.
Ride on, Jesus, ride on, King Jesus, ride on, conquering King, I wonder.
Anything you can think of you want to ask? Somebody's going to break the ice on this. Somebody, yes.
The first soprano, what are your vocal exercises?
We have two first sopranos there, so.
I like to do sirens, see how far I can go, see how low I can go, just sort of fill in all the notes in between. I do a lot of melisma, so like,
Good questions. Anything else? Other questions?
So what majors do you offer in music?
In music? Okay. We've got this interesting time right now because we're redoing a lot of our degrees. What we've done is we have a Bachelor of Arts. Last semester, we went into the Bachelor of Arts and established the core courses that deal with more modern needs for the musician. What we've discovered is most music curricula were written in the 1800s, and that's long before anybody thought about what an iPad could do or anything along that line, or electronics. So what we've done is we've put in courses that kind of bring that up to date, but also teach you how to do a nonprofit, how to do your taxes if you're going to be a sole proprietor. Those types of things. So the BA now has different tracks. So you can go business track, you can go performance track, you can go recording industry track, that type of thing.
BA, that means Bachelor of Arts.
Yeah, Bachelor of Arts in Music. And then our core courses, the biggest program is a Bachelor of Music. And what we're doing, we just had a meeting last week, and what we're doing is we've pared those down a little bit from things that are not needed as often. But we've added that core as a possibility. And so you can either take the core and not do student teaching, or you can do student teaching and not take the core, or you can do student teaching as a certificate. So things like that. So it's really bringing those into the program. We have an excellent music theory and composition degree. We've got people right now that are really successful. We've got one guy out in LA that's writing music for video games. And that's his job right now. And we've got one choral composer who recently graduated, who is now in Cambridge University and finishing their graduate degree, and he's actually getting some really good work out there. The ACA is going to pay for him to come over to the National Conference and do a presentation. So that's a strong program.
Of course, you'll see how many music ed-books we have, right? Raise your hands, music ed-books.
And this is not all of them. So we have our concert choir has maybe 27, 28 voice majors in it. And so a lot of those are music ed as well.
So what are the different ensembles that you've got?
Okay, five choruses. We have a women's chorus and men's chorus, and those don't require audition. We have the Chattanooga Singers, which is the concert choir, and which right now Chattanooga Singers is mostly majors.
The concert choir meaning it's a larger ensemble.
Mm-hmm, yeah. And then we have this chorus, which is our main touring chorus. And then we have in the summer, just an on-call class in the summer, it's a master chorale, which is mainly geared for our graduate students. But we have, every once in a while, some undergraduates are in it, and a lot of people from the community are in it. So those are the five choruses that we've got. Okay. Yes, sir?
In what ways, mainly music education majors, in what ways music education specifically incorporate music, particularly choral performance, into like the education part of this
Good question. Singers especially get into that.
I'm actually in choral methods right now, which is like, I wish I had taken this class all 4 years that I've been here, because it's really about how to teach choir. You know, I've had elementary music methods, how to teach elementary music, how to teach middle school music. I really want to teach high school. So I have had some like education courses where you sort of have to modify what you're hearing to apply to like music classrooms. Because music classrooms are way different than like math classrooms or what have you. But I'd say it's really interesting to see how teachers are learning to teach versus how music teachers are learning.
because it's so much different than just teaching, because you're teaching music and you're teaching students. And you've got all these other things you can incorporate, you know, theory, your training, sight reading, anything you can squeeze in there. You're not just teaching literature. So there's a lot of different layers to it, I guess.
Part of our course redesign, too.
We're finally doing what I wanted to do for years, and we're having two semesters of all music commitments. So the senior high, it's always been a plus. And so starting with the new curriculum, there'll be two of them.
Anything else?
Do y'all offer any scholarships in your music?
Absolutely. Yeah, we, especially for majors. If you go to major in music, that's where the bulk of the scholarship money goes. What we do, we will have a little bit of money left over at the first of the year, and we'll try to balance the ensemble with staff and non-majors. So if we wind up with all sopranos and no basses, then we'll give some base scholarships at the beginning of the year. That's how we think for non-majors. But if you're a major, by all means, there are two audition dates, February 25th and March 25th. And those those are entrants into the program as well as scholarship.
That's what got me, actually. I was not a music major when I started college. I was a physics major. That's why you tell me, right? But I love singing choirs. It clicked for me, and I switched over. And my major was music education, and I fulfilled all requirements for sacred music and vocal performance. Music education was my main major in college.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's a good indication. We do have some scholarships. And some of these people are actually finally going to graduate, so that free up some
scholarships. I was a non-major, but I did get a scholarship to sing in the choir. I sang it in high school. I loved it. I auditioned with a different director when I first got there. But I auditioned for him, got a vocal grant, and that was my thing that got me in there.
Yes?
True passion for music. Preparation for once you actually get out of college as well, especially like what I'm trying to pursue is a professional singer as in a choir or do a studio singer back in singing. So you have to do a lot of auditions in order to attain those kind of jobs. And so that was part of the reason why I wanted to make the first step to audition.
We don't have, well, I guess it just depends on what your major is, on how your free time is managed. But I joined because I knew that the group was going to be like a bond, like somewhere I could go to just, okay, I know, I do love music, and I'm a music major, but I need to go and sing or talk to my friends for a while. And we spend 4 days out of the week with each other, so it's like, we should know each other.
That's true. It does become a family after a while, it really does. Any other questions? Should we sing another one for you?
Yes.
Okay.
Let's do the
piano. So this is French, so it'll be a little different tone. It'll be a lighter tone for this one. This was mid to late 20th century French, so it's a little influenced by jazz. So the harmonies will be a little closer together. It's not jazz, but it's influenced by that. So you hear the closeness of the harmonies. This is Hymn to the Virgin by Pierre Vian. And the soloist is Caleb Petrilli, I think.
Are you going to do this or are you going to do that?
She's going to do this?
So Glory's going to do this.
I've never heard Glory sing this soloist.
Y'all
need
to come down?
You can do whatever you want.
Thank you.
and this just dawned on me in the middle of him singing this. If you never become a musician, the study that you're doing with music right now pays off. Let me explain how it does. It's a weird thing. But the way the brain works, you train the brain to think in ways. And the way musicians are different, and they're markedly different, and a brain anatomist can actually look at a CT scan or a MRI scan and tell if you're a musician or not. They can tell that because different parts of the brain are larger. And what happens is you learn to think from many different directions at the same time as a musician. That skill is highly valued, whether it's in music or not. I have my sister-in-law is in the HR department of one of the large insurance companies downtown. An awful lot of her call center hires have been from the chamber singers, because what they found out is that they outperform everybody else. And she finally told me over the holidays, she said, we would now rather hire UTC music majors than UTC business majors. Please don't tell Jerry that. But she's actually said that. She said they will come to us every time they have an opening because of the way the musician's brain works. And so what you're doing really pays off, even if you don't become a musician. It pays off in the way in which you approach problems. You generally don't run into a problem and stop. You run into a problem and work your way around it. And that's the way you do music. That's the only way to figure out these notes and rhythms and pitches and all of the stuff together. So, very good. Any other questions? At all? They are bugging me about doing True Religion. And if we do True Religion, did you sing bass or baritone?
Singing one.
Okay. Are you missing baritone?
Oh, I'm singing baritone.
You sing baritone. We need bass.
Okay.
All right. All right. So instead of doing the distro, why don't we do the true? And the reason Glory sang the solo in the last one is because Kayla has both of these solos and she didn't want it to be an all Kayla show. Kayla has done really well this year. She was hired to go to Memphis and sing the solos for Will Todd's Mass in Blue, when Will Todd coming over from England to play. And so she just got back from that. And I think she had a good time.
That was fun.
All right, the next piece we're doing is one of his signature pieces, one of Roland Carter's signature pieces called You Must Have That True Religion. So this will be the last thing we sing for you. I've left some cards also with Mr. Barnell, and if you're interested in UTC and you want to find out anything about it, if you fill out the card, he will collect them, because you're not all here, right? You've got some other students who couldn't be here. I think some of the core students couldn't be here. He'll collect them and send them to you. And we'll send you some material and let you know what's going on there. So if there are no final questions, then you must have that true religion.
You must have that true.
From Musa. No, Musa. No, Annie just.
We'll start a little bit.
Annie's saying she didn't know she was here.